and at the top here a bit more. Well, we have to be careful and not overdo it. This flower is white. We'll be careful. And this should be more dark. And we will try to do dark background here and try to wipe some stuff. Okay, so now I will use dry brush and do this. Also, we can splash some clean water. And here as well. It will give us nice texture. And here, why not? Let's see what happens. Yeah, it gives us springtime texture straight away. Okay, so I will go with the water over this area again. It's nice. While it is wet, we can do some green petals. Now most of the picture is nearly ready, so we can have some fun and play around a little bit like this. And green stuff here. Leaves. Now I'm taking background closer to the flower. Keep outline of the flower. Unnecessary spaces. So we have dark background and white flower, only one here, which is white. Some little leaves. Now these flowers are becoming dry. You can put more leaves here. Like this. Yeah, nice green color. Looks actually more lively when you do it on wet paper. And we will be quick to finish our last petals here. leave some white area for yellow middle. The dark, so it looks more natural. Take it to this tender stem, which will be lighter than background. You know, it's funny, half of the picture is done on dry paper and now we are creating some lively effects. I just wanted to see different techniques. This pattern, gray. When it gets dry, we will do some details, so we will not be forgotten these flowers. While it is a bit humid, we can do some leaves, maybe. Transparent. More attention to this petal and to this petal. It is in front, this flower is in front. We can do second layer of work. Sometimes if it is background, we can just use one wet and wet layer, but here it will take the image of the flower closer to our eyes. Here is quite nice. What we have to do, make outline for this middle part here. Some yellow at the second flower behind. Couple of spots. Also take one side of it with a brush so it looks more lively. Maybe more juicy outline here. Make some volume and continue this petal. Take this color inside and take this side. And a bit more probably on this flower as well. Middle part here. We have to add some yellow, so it is logic why we left this space. And do some yellow on this white flower here. Also make sure that people understand what is this sticking out here? It is just white crocus. Yeah, we don't have to do more details. Maybe some stem for it as well. We even can't see properly what's going on there. Some drop. Yeah, what is jumping into our eye now? This is too white. We need to keep this in front. This is a bit too light as well. So we take a flat brush, wipe it, and just calm down some areas. And this is keep them together. You can see details still, but it keeps together all detailed work. So do some shading here. And what I will do, will do some splashing probably in this area. It is a bit boring here, we need more texture. Maybe something here. Yeah, we have nice textures here. Let's see what happens. I will take blue, bluish color to do some splashing here. Maybe even darker color a little bit. Well, so it's shining is here and here. Remember not overdo it. Water, maybe even pinky water. Pink. Let's see. where we can see spots which we don't need, for example, here. Wipe it. While it's wet, the drops are wet, we can wipe. Push the paint around. Lines, dry grass. Yes, we are finishing the work now. I'm just doing last corrections. Still this side near the front. Crocus is quite boring, so we just try to play around with it. And maybe some dark. Dark stuff here as well. Let's do dark green. Maybe the flowers will shine a bit more. And let's see where else. Maybe too much dark. We don't need too much dark. Or maybe we can just stop. Let's do here. Stone here. Stone, we can use dry brush on the stone. Give it more volume. Brush, dry brush here. Yeah, guys, I think that we should stop now. Otherwise, too good is not good as well. Let's do final splash. See what happens here. And here. And I will sign the picture on the left. Thank you for watching. I will show you close up. Sorry.